Friends, the next tag is how to add audio and video to the HTML documents. Okay. How to add audio and video. It's also very simple. You should have a video file or audio file in your computer. You should know the source. Where does it resides in your computer? Okay. So you have to specify the particular location, then you can add it. So the tag, it's going to be audio only. It's going to be for audio, for adding audio as well as a video file. Okay. So next heading is adding audio and video files in your HTML program. Okay, so to add an audio or a video, the tag it's going to be audio only. Audio. Then you have to specify the location of the file. That is src is equal to, with a double quotation, you have to specify the file name. Okay. So I have a file in my folder. Okay, so you can just specify wherever you have in your computer. So /mongguide. Then the audio file name you have to specify. Whatever the name it has, you have to specify MP3 file. Okay, so song.mp3. That's all. This is a audio tab. No need to close it. And for video also same, audio src is equal to, specify the location where it resides in your computer, /movie.mp4. Wherever it resides and whatever the name it is, you just specify, that will be added. Got it? Okay. And this, for adding audio and video, which has attributes, which has many attributes. Okay, if you want, you can specify the attributes or you can just simply leave it. So let me read out the attributes from the text. All of you take your text, page number 44. Page number 44, please take it. Ready? Yes. So if you take a audio, inserting audio heading, just look at the box here. Okay, box here, the attributes. The first attribute, it's autoplay. So if you give a attribute called autoplay, whenever you add an audio, automatically it will play. That means autoplay. Then controls. So if you want to specify the timings in the video or audio, then you have to use the attribute called controls. Then loop. Loop means repeating again and again. So if you use a loop attribute, the video or audio will be played again and again. Okay. Then muted. So you know what is meant by mute, right? Which will be silent mode. Okay. Then preload, which checks how it should load or when it should load. That is called preload. Then source, src means the link where the file resides, the audio or a video file resides. Okay. So now all of you turn to page, next to page 45, and see the attributes for video. Okay. So video also same. Then you can specify the height of the video. Okay. The size it should occupy, as we did it for the image. Okay. Height and width you can specify. Then autoplay, control, loop, everything it's same. Okay. Then poster is there. Turn to the next page. Poster means it provides an image that is to be shown while the video it's downloading or for the first loads. It will show the image of the particular audio or a video when it loaded for the first time, which is called poster. Then remaining are same. Only height and width and poster are added to this video. Clear? All right, students. We will work out the same also in the practical session.
Students, the next 1 minute, how to add audio and a video to a HTML program. That means adding audio and a video in a web page. Got it? Okay, so first let me go to notepad. I opened a notepad. Okay, so here is a notepad. Let me start typing the program as usual. HTML. Okay, then head. In the head, you can specify the font. Okay, face is equal to, you can specify any face. Algerian. Then size is equal to 60. Then color is equal to any color you can specify. Brown, I have given brown color. Okay, then the font tag is over. Next, I would like to give a underline for the heading, so I have given underline, and italic also I want to specify, also bold. Everything I have specified over here. After that, what is the heading you're going to give? Please provide it here. So this is adding audio and video. Audio and video to a web page. So I have given the heading as adding audio and video. So close all the tags which you open, underline, italic, then bold handwriting, then glossed font also. I closed it. Okay. So heading, it's over. After heading, it should be title. Okay, so title I'm giving. So title you can give a suitable title. Audio I'm giving, so close the title, then close the head also. Here comes the body section. So in the body, I would like to apply the background color is equal to hexadecimal number again. So ABC 987 I have given. Okay, then so new paragraph I'm opening. Paragraph align is equal to left. Okay, so in the paragraph you can type anything as you need. So I'm going to add a audio and a video file. This is one of the audio and video files I'm adding for the first time in HTML program. Let's see how does it works. Okay, so the paragraph I have written. Then after the paragraph, give a line break. Okay, so otherwise the video will be on the same line. Okay, I have given two line breaks, BR, BR. Then I'm going to add one audio and one video. Okay, so first audio. If I specify audio, then the file, it's what, even though if you are specifying the video file here in audio, you will get only the sound. Okay, because you have opened the tag with the name audio. Then controls is equal to controls. So controls means what are the buttons, like a pass button, go forward, backward. Those controls will be displayed when you specify this controls. So it is must to give. Okay, then src is equal to double quotation, open a double quotation. Then let me go ahead and find the location of the audio file. Okay, so here I'm clicking go to the file explorer or Windows Explorer. Okay, go to the place where you have your files. So I'm going to my folder. Okay, so in my folder, class 8, I'm teaching you the video, right? So let me take from chapter 3, let me take any one video. Okay, so shall I take image.html? Okay, image.html mp4. So this is a video, I'm going to take it. Okay, so this location, click on the address bar, you will get it. So it is given as D drive slash the folder names slash class 8 slash chapter 3. So copy, control C to copy, and then file name, it's image space html dot mp4. Okay, so where does I have to go? Let me go to notepad and paste this, and also add the file name. Okay, what is the file name? Image html dot mp4, okay, double quotation closed. And if you want, you can give a heightened width. It's not required because it's an audio file, right? Okay, so audio, it's over. No need to close the audio. Then I'm closing this paragraph. Okay, I'm closing this paragraph. Paragraph tag, and then closing the body tag, then closing HTML. Okay, so the program, it's over. Let me save it. Okay, I'm saving it with a usual folder. Okay, so name it's audio dot html. Never ever forget to give dot html. So we have saved it. Then go to file, run window. Here in the run, browse for the file. Okay. So go ahead and take all files, and here audio.html is a file we created now. So click on OK button. Now, do you see adding audio and video, but nothing it's displayed here, right? Let's see what happened. Nothing is there. So that means we have made a mistake in the codings. Okay, so don't get panic. What happened? Just we will go ahead and find it out. Okay, so brown color, we have given italic, underline, bold, everything it's applied. So title closed, title, see title spelling wrong. Did you notice, students notice title title, right? But I have given title. So even a single mistake, spelling mistake, won't give you the proper display. Okay, now do you see it is displayed? F5 button I press, now you can see the display. Because of that one single spelling mistake, the entire page was not displayed. Okay, so you have to be very careful with the spellings. Now do you see, if you want to maximize, let me maximize. This is one of my audio and video files I'm adding for the first time in HTML. Let's see how does it work. See, do you see the controls? Okay, volume button is there, pause and start button. See, you can hear one.
Let us add image to an HTML program.
Okay. So click on pause button. Okay, so the audio it's added now. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a video file over here itself. Down, I want to add a video file. Okay, so let me take here. Okay, then go to the program. Okay, before closing the paragraph. Okay, so paragraph it's closed. Let me open another paragraph. This is right. I'm going to align to the center. Okay, center, and in this paragraph, this is one of the videos of my daughter. Okay, you can take your own video and you can upload it. Okay, daughter, then we have to open video. Okay, so actually for adding audio you have to use the tag audio, and for video you have to use the word video. During the board teaching, I for both I have written audio only. Okay, that was a mistake, please correct it. Controls is equal to controls. Okay, then src is equal to open double quotation, and just go and find the file which you are going to add it. Okay, so now I want to add a file which is in my daughter's folder. Okay, so where is that? Okay, just give me a second, let me find out. Okay, so this is the one I'm going to take it. Okay, let it be this one, Independence Day by Akshaya Umayal dot mp4. Okay, it's a big name, so let me rename it, otherwise it will be too big to inde.mp4 is a file name. Okay, so this is a file I'm going to add it. So let me see the location. It is C D drive. Okay, so copy the location, then inde.mp4. okay, so space the location slash inde.mp4, close it. Okay. Then height and width also you can specify. For video, height is equal to 30% and width is equal to, it is again 30%. Okay. Then we can close this video tag. Okay. Then close this paragraph also. Fine. So the paragraph, I'm closing it. So the program, it's over. Now we have added video file also. Already we added an audio file over here. Now newly we have added a video file. Okay. Then you can see the difference. So let me take the web page. This is a web page we have. So after making changes, we have to press the F5 key. F5. See, it is looks too smaller, right? Because of the height and width, it displays very too small. Shall we go ahead and change the height and width? Because it is not visible, right? Let me change it into 80%. And here also it is 80%. Okay. So I have given, let us see how does it looks like. File, save. Okay. Then I closed that browser. Let me open it again. Go to run, browse. Okay, take the file. It's audio, right? So I'm taking the file. Okay button. Yes, now do you see? This is the way it displays. Okay, so this is a video file. You can take your own videos, upload it in your computer and add it to your HTML program. This is a audio file and this is a video file, and you can see the controls play. Okay, so this is the way we add audio and video files to the HTML document. Is it clear, students? So because of 80%, you can say this much bigger. Clear? Very good. Okay. So I hope everyone understood about something about HTML programs. That is how to create or design the web pages and make it as a website. Okay. So the basic tags I taught you. So please, using these tags, try to create your own web page and send it to me. Okay, let it be an assignment for you all. Those who can do, please do it. Those who don't have a computer, don't worry. When the school reopens, you can do it from the lab computers. Okay, so this is for the students who have a computer. Please work out and just design a web page and send it to me. Those who don't have, please write only the codings. Okay, in a notebook, A4 size paper, assignment paper, write only the codings. Once the school reopens, you can just type it in the computer and you can show it to me your website. Got it? That's good, students. So this is the chapter HTML, more about links. And I have taught you about the basic tags in HTML, how to write a HTML program, then how to do a ordered list and unordered list, how to add links, how to add images, and how to add image as a hyperlink. Okay, then how to add audio and video to the HTML documents, that is to your web page. I hope everyone is clear with the concept what I taught for this chapter. And students, in your text, please see whatever I taught, the same thing you have to study. If something is different, it's given, no need to study. Okay, I think only one page has a different thing, because if I want to teach that, it will take another two classes. Okay, so because of the time, I'm just winding up this chapter over here. After completing the portion for term one, if I get a time, definitely I'll teach you more tags in HTML. Okay, all right, students. So we will discuss the question and answers. That means exercise questions now, and we will wind up the session. Got it? Students, let us do the exercise questions. So I request everyone to turn to the page number 47. Okay, so first let's see the box which is given as I know now. Okay, that is what we are going to study. So first one, a link or a hyperlink is a connection from one web resource to another. Is that correct? So one page to another page, how do we move? Using a link, or we call it as hyperlink. Okay, so that is what given in the first line. Then our link has two ends called anchors. Yes, when we start the link tag, we started with the A and then we ended with a slash A. So both are anchors only, right? So which has a two ends, one it's starting and the one it's ending. Okay, they are called anchors. Then hyperlinks are defined with the HTML A tag. Okay, so anchor links are specified with the first letter anchor A. Okay. Then attributes are added to a tag to provide the browser with more information about how the tag should appear or behave. See, attribute in the sense, we are adding with the tags. Okay, so say for example, let us take the tag called font. Okay, so in the font tag, if I specify only font, what will happen? Nothing will happen, right? So inside the font, we are adding three attributes. What are they? Face, size and color. So these three are called attributes of a font tag. So when I give an attribute which tells the browser how does it's going to appear or behave in the web page. Okay, so dash tells the browser how it is going to behave, the attributes. All right. Okay, the audio tag has been added to HTML5 to allow embedding audio files to a web page. Okay, this feature, it's the latest newly added feature from HTML5. So which feature they added? Adding audio file to the web page. Okay, then all of you look at fill in the blanks. Question number one, dash allow users to move seamlessly from one page to another. Okay, dash is allowing to move from one page to another. So how do we move from one page to another? Using which one? Link, right? So we have to call it as hyperlinks. So answer for first question is hyperlinks. Okay, then second one, a link has two ends called anchors, starting with the A symbol and then ending with the slash A. So they are called anchors, A-N-C-H-O-R-S, anchors. Okay, third one, a dash is a link to the same website and is specified with a relative URL. A dash is a link to the same website. That means relative URL means it's locally it is linked. Okay, so that is called, it's a local link. A local link is a same website. A local link is a same website and is specified with a relative URL. Got it? Okay, then next one, dash are added to a tag to provide the browser with more information about how the tag should appear or behave. So just now we discussed, right? So with the tag, what we are providing? We are providing attributes to make the browser understand how does the tag will behave. Okay, so answer for fourth question, it's attributes. Fifth one, the dash attribute specifies where to open the linked document. The dash attribute specifies where to open the linked document. The answer is target. Okay, the answer is target. We did not discuss, but you please write the answer, target. Then true or false, a link can never be an image element. See, when we do the link, they are telling that we cannot have an image as a link. Is that true? No, right? We have done through the practical session. Na? So we can just make a image as a link. So the statement it's given here, it's false. First one, false. The href, hyper reference attribute, specifies the destination address of the link. Yes, we say a href is equal to, in double quotation, we provide the address of the file. So it specifies the destination address. So second answer, it's true. Attributes consist of a name and a value separated by ampersand sign. So you know what is attribute, right? With the help of a font tag we studied. Font, what is the name of the attribute? Face. Then what we do is equal to, in double quotation, we write something. So what is separating the name and the what is the name equal to symbol? But here they have given ampersand sign, so it is false. So third question answer, it's false. Links can also be styled as buttons. Yes, we can also make it as a buttons. We did not study, but make it true. Okay. The path to an audio file can contain an absolute or relative URLs. Yes, we can have an absolute or relative URLs. Then take the correct answer. When you move the mouse over a link, the mouse arrow will turn into a little finger, hand, foot, or a ball. So during the link, how does it changes into? It changes into a hand symbol. Okay. So answer it's hand. A link starts at the dash anchor. So the link will be starting with a dash anchor source. Hyperlinks are defined with the HTML dash tag. So hyperlinks we are specifying with the A tag, anchor tag. Okay. The link starts at the dash tag target anchor. So in the next page, two more questions are there. They are we did not cover those portions. Okay. According to the time, we are just adjusting the classes and the portions. Okay. So this is all the exercise questions and answer the following. I'll send it through WhatsApp students. Okay, all of you write it neatly in your computer notebook as well as study the same because your exams are nearing. Okay, stay home, stay safe. Thank you, students.